to the last part of all four steps. I'm catching at the elbow once again, but this time I've used a left foot pivot. Meaning when I say left foot pivot, my left foot stays on the ground and I'm opening up to my defender. Now I've showed the right hand drive. I've showed the right hand step back. I've showed the right hand jab, drive, cutoff, fadeaway. And at this point, your defender has no idea what you're gonna do. He thinks you're gonna drive, he thinks you're gonna fade, he thinks you're gonna step back. So now you're in your comfort zone. You're basically telling the defender what you want him to do. In your mind, you already know what you're gonna do. And you're gonna read the defender. And if he doesn't move, say the defender doesn't move this time, now you go around him. But you're giving yourself space. You jab once, okay, he doesn't move, and you jab again, that's giving you more than enough room to get your balance square. Your feet is square with your shoulders, and you're in perfect balance to get that ball right above the rim and give yourself an opportunity to make a shot. So at this point, I've caught it from my offensive player, my point guard. Left foot pivot, I've opened up, and it's just easy. You give him the jab because he may think you may go right. He doesn't really back up that much. But on the second one, you give him a hard jab, he drops his foot, and you're able to raise for the shot. Contested shot, but much easier shot because you've beat him on the drive once or twice before. You've beat him left hand. You've got to the rim. You've embarrassed him once or twice. So now you can just shoot a comfortable jumper right in his face, and everybody can enjoy the night, and the crowd go crazy. Got it. Oh. Oh. Got it.